I would like to play first. I'd like to mulligan. This deck has not had the smoothest opening hand so far. I mean, I did draw really well in that one mulligan to six, but other than that, I've taken a fair amount of mulligans. Though things have worked out. I guess I'm in the finals. Can't complain too much. But this hand's fine. I mean, my opponent also mulled to six, and if I draw any land, this hand's actually quite good. But can't obviously misfire. All right, there we go. If I can play Splatter Thug into Racketeer, and then Clue Stone into Phantom, and then have a Clan Defiance, I'm in good shape. If I miss on this turn, it's fairly bad. Ooh, new Nuprov Guildmage is good. All right, well, let's just get start with the Splatter Thug. Not only does this hit for more damage, it also gives me more turns to draw things to discard to Racketeer, since I don't mind discarding like a Clue Stone if I need to, but I would rather just discard like an Incursion Specialist or some loose blue card that I draw. Certainly wouldn't be discarding a land though. Oh wow, that was a good draw for me if I draw a land, which I did. Alright, I'm just gonna Clan Defiance here since it takes two creatures off the board. And also the Nuprov Guildmage later in the game can mess up Clan Defiance pretty significantly, since if you target a non-flyer then it just gains flying, then that will in fact fizzle it, as Shahar found out in our testing with Beetleform Mage. But yeah, Clan Defiance is six, so that puts me in a pretty good spot here, I think. Not sure what the swamps are in my opponent's deck. So far, I've only seen, good ban cards. Actually, very good ban cards. So either the black cards are very good, or my opponent's deck was short a bunch of playables and is just showing me the high end. We'll see, I guess. So if I draw an island, I'm just slamming the Phantom Menace, and then if I don't, I probably end up playing Racketeer. Discarding, whatever nonsense I draw. I don't. The Clue Stone's actually fine here, but if I draw an island, I wouldn't mind discarding it. All right, Splatter Thug is beating down still, which is nice. Yeah, Clan Defiance is a messed up card. I'm not unhappy that I took it. Amo would still be something I'd have to battle against. Boom. All right, well, appreciated. I did spike a top 16 to remain platinum, which I'm pretty happy about. All right, well, that's a fairly easy card to discard, I think. I mean, I'd rather just play a creature, and I don't want to discard the Clue Stone. I think I can actually discard Weapon Surge. Splatter Thug already has First Strike, so I think trading that off is fine. Also, Dimir Clue Stone for my opponent was not the power play that I was worried about. Lavinia of the Tenth is still a card I'm going to have trouble beating. I guess Leyline Phantom actually does a good job against it, but not only do I have two red creatures out, she actually even detains them both. So, yeah, that was one of the better rares in the set, undoubtedly. Let's see if that's what's coming out this turn. Oh no, Bronzebeak Moa. That does not frighten me in the slightest. Runner's Bane not great against it, though it can delay it for a few turns. But I think just bashing is pretty good here. My opponent didn't even leave Deputy of Acquittal's mana up, which would have given me pause if that was the case. Oop, no, this is First Strike. Let's not tap my mana during First Strike. But since they didn't, then I get to attack without fear and play a Leyline Phantom, which I think is pretty good right now. Returning the hand is not a big disadvantage when I don't have very many cards in hand and my opponent's at such low life total. Attacking your opponent from 20 to 15 is not very good with this thing, but attacking them from 7 to 2 is significantly better. And the Runner's Bane, even as just a temporary fog on the or a tap on the Moa, is pretty good. There is Lavinia. Well, the Leyline Phantom still gets to do some work here, so I'm not unhappy about that. Deputy of Acquittal's nat mana is now active, which is much less good for me, but the Moa probably wouldn't attack if the deputy was around, I think. That's not necessarily true, but because blocking with Lavinia then bouncing it is also pretty reasonable, but Opponent now tanking. Well, I think I have to attack with Leyline Phantom regardless. Wow, the deputy's gonna cast now? That seems ambitious. I mean, I take more damage, but now the deputy doesn't get to bounce Lavinia. So basically, I'm taking an extra three, but my opponent's gonna take an extra five off the Leyline Phantom. All right, well, I guess that's fine. I will just hit with the Leyline Phantom. Or the deputy's dying, I guess that's also a thing. And I get to replay the Phantom afterwards to block. All right, well, deputy dying is fine, I suppose. Return that. Sadly, can't play Cluestone and the Phantom, but that's okay. Alright. So now Lavidia comes down. I can get attacked down to 5, but then the Leyland Phantom gets to bash. I also will probably end up Runner's Baning the Bronzebeak Moa. Again, whenever my opponent plays a creature, the Runner's Bane will fall off, but that buys me at least an untapped step, which is very relevant. Alright, so what happens now? I guess I can get attacked to 5 and then attack with a Leyline Phantom. Then my opponent goes to 2 and then has a Moa and a Lavinia in play, and I'm in trouble if my opponent draws any sort of creature. That's gotta be better though. I can't block with Phantom here and leave the board as 2 red creatures against a Lavinia. That just does not make sense, I don't think. Do I want to draw another Deputy of Akotos? No, Shamble Shark. Alright, well, this is much less good for me. Alright, so an island. So I guess I Runner's Bane the Shamble Shark and smash with Leyline Phantom. And then can untap and play the Phantom afterwards. Now, I'm at 2. Yeah, that works fine. The Racketeer can then chump the Moa on my opponent's turn. And Leyland Phantom can block Lavinia. So unless my opponent draws another creature, I'm in pretty good shape here. Of course, if that does happen, then I'm in much worse shape. Alright. Get in there. A Leyland Phantom. Alright. I suspect my opponent goes to 2 here. That seems like the play. Also, I put myself dead if I didn't draw an island, if my opponent just takes it, so it does seem reasonable to take that gamble. Not that I necessarily wouldn't have or would have attacked if I didn't have an island, but it could be a pretty sick bluff. I mean, probably not the right play at that point, but alright, so let's do that. And Leyland Phantom. Alright, so again, I'm pretty far ahead if my opponent bricks this turn. I actually just win if my opponent bricks this turn. If my opponent draws any sort of creature, then I have to chump the Moa. Alright, now my opponent's just dead, so that is helpful. I get to block Lavinia, block Moa, kill Splatter Thug, or just attack with all 3 of my creatures. So, a close game, but the Clan Defiance was quite the beating. Oh, sorry, yeah, my opponent does have a Cluestone, so at 2 draw steps. Alright, so I certainly haven't just won. Okay, just for the Cluestone was just kind of sitting there getting ignored, so I think this is a last-ditch effort attack, but I mean, it doesn't change the way I block. These are forced blocks here. If combat resolves, then yeah. Alright. Yeah, a bunch of flash creatures in Lavinia. Does Simic Charm do anything special? I don't think it does. This doesn't really match up against the Bronzebeak Moas, neither do the stupid walls, so given that that's the case, I don't think I necessarily decided anything. Alright.